Hi, this is Matt with Custom Car Grills here with a mesh install for 2017 and newer Hyundai Elantra Sport. Once the grill has been removed from the bumper, the first thing I'll do is flip it around to work on the back. There's a couple little black plastic pieces near the lower corners that need to be removed. I believe these are placeholders for if the car is equipped with front sensors. The Elantra I'm working on doesn't have sensors, so I think I'm good to go for this mod. Next, I'll grab an open-ended handsaw to make the first cuts. I like to start the cutting with the thin vertical support bars on the bottom and top. I'm getting close to the edge with these cuts, but not directly on the edge. After that, I'll grab my Dremel and equip it with the number 561 multi-purpose cutting bit. This makes short work of cutting through most of the solid area of the grill. Again, I'm staying close to the edge, but I'm avoiding cutting into the edge because I'll sand that down later. If a spiral cutting bit isn't available, an open-ended handsaw can be used here too. It's a little bit more work to use the saw, but it's a viable option. With all the cuts made, the center section should lift out with ease and can be discarded. Now, I'll equip my Dremel with the sanding drum attachment and start sanding the excess plastic on the edge. I'm working my way right up to the edge, but it's important not to sand too deep past the edge itself. Next, with the number 543 cutting wheel attachment, there's a couple tabs that need to be cut off flush to the rest of the back of the grill. Here's a quick peek at how the grill should look now. The inside portion is removed and the inside edge has been rough sanded down. Next, I'll grab some 100 grit sandpaper and refine this edge down a little further to get a smoother surface. Oftentimes, it's easier to feel the unevenness of the edge with hand sanding like this. Ideally, it would be great to strip off the black finish from the grill at this point too. Unfortunately, it's not always that easy, and I enlisted the help of my Dremel again. To strip the grill down to bare plastic, I'm barely applying any pressure at all here. It's only a very tiny bit of material that's being removed, and once I see it change from black to white, then I move on to the next area. Once the black is stripped off the inner edge, I'll go back and do some more sanding. On this pass, I'm still using a pretty aggressive sandpaper, and I'm trying to scuff up the plastic so that we'll have something to grip onto in later steps. Here's a quick look at how the inner edge now looks with all of the sanding that I've done thus far. This looks pretty good so far, but now I need to address the issue that should be pretty obvious at this point. After the horizontal bars were removed, I'm left with a bunch of notches on the sides that will need to be filled. Typically, I would try to reinforce the back of this with some mesh, and that's usually the best course of action. In this case, there's so many attachment points that we can't block them all off with mesh and repair material. Instead, I'm going to use some craft tape to build up a barrier on the back of the grill. This will give me something to apply some plastic repair material and without risking a lot of spillover. Speaking of plastic repair material, I'm using Valvoline's PlyoGrip Plastic Repair No. 3 to get the job done. Once I have the mix tube equipped, I'll start dispensing the material right in the openings like so. This stuff sets up pretty quick, so I'll need to work fast. With it all dispensed, I'll grab a squeegee and spread the material around a little bit for a nice even edge. The top and bottom edges can be filled as well. For now, I think I'm going to see if I can get away with filling these small divots with finishing putty. The putty I like to use is Blaze Glaze, as seen here. I'm just going to dispense a small amount and then add a pinch of hardener. Now, I'll mix it all up until I have a light greenish-bluish look. This can usually be applied directly to the raw plastic. If this happens to crack, chip, or flake off the plastic, then it'll be best to first apply some more PlyoGrip or panel bond material to this edge and redo it. Okay, so by now, the PlyoGrip has hardened and the tape wall can be removed. Since the side wall is so thin at this point, I'm trying to be careful and remove the tape gently. If it doesn't feel strong enough, then additional repair material may need to be added. We can see from this top-down view just how thin this side area is, but also see some areas that were able to be built up a little thicker. Next, it's back to the sandpaper again, and a bit of sanding on the plyo grip plastic repair material. This step will be very important to get right. It's essentially the final shape of the edge that will be seen on the finished product. I'll make a final pass over this with some blaze glaze finishing putty afterward, but this will only add a thin layer and help fill in pinholes. Once that's all set up, I'll sand it down with some fine grit sandpapers. The end result should look like this. A nice, smooth, consistent edge all the way around. No cracks, chips, or pinholes present, and I think we're good to go for paint. This is how it turned out after painting it all flat black. Overall, this looks really good, especially when we consider what it started as. There's a nice, clean, consistent edge, and I think I'm ready to finally install the mesh. Here's a look at the mesh piece we have for sale on our website. This is pre-cut and pre-bent specifically for the 2017 and newer Hyundai Elantra Sport model, and has a nice flat black finish as seen here. If any front sensors are equipped on the vehicle, additional modifications to fit them onto the mesh will be needed. With all the right cuts made on the grill frame, the mesh piece should drop right onto the back of it as seen here. To temporarily hold the mesh to the grill frame, I'm going to use some cable ties and foam. It's just simply a matter of looping the tie around the grill and through the mesh, and then firmly fastening them together. I like having the tail end of the tie on the back of the mesh. That usually gives the best hold from my experience. This close-up shot is a great example on how to get it done right. Once all the ties are in place, then the tail ends can be cut off and discarded. Before permanently bonding the mesh and grill together, I'm going to give it a look over to make sure that there's no gaps and everything lines up right. I've got lots of plyo grip left over, so I'll use that as the material to attach the mesh on. I'm strategically applying the plyo grip in areas where the mesh comes in contact with the back of the grill. It's super important to make sure that none spills through the front of the mesh at this point. In this close-up, it's easy to see that I'm navigating around the mounting tabs as well. Once the plyo grip hardens, the ties can be cut off and the foam can be removed and discarded. Whew, the mesh install is now complete. Let's flip it around and see how it turned out. Wow, this looks really good. The mesh in the frame looks seamless, and the flat black finish has a great OEM finish to it. Overall, this mod wasn't too hard. With a moderate amount of time, skills, and tools, I think this would make for a good weekend project. This really is a must-have mod for any Elantra Sport owner that's looking to upgrade the appearance of their front end. I hope you liked this video. If you have any questions about it, feel free to contact me.